We start tonight at the Celtic Festival, wrapping up day two at Riverscape Metro Park. This year, officials took a number of precautions to ensure everyone stays safe. 2 News reporter Evan Bale spent the day at the Celtic Fest and has more on those security measures.
At the Celtic Festival, dozens of moving parts come together for a fun-filled weekend with good food, drinks, and a safe environment. But for an event like this, what kind of security goes into it? I'm here to find out.
Months and months of planning all come together here at Dayton's Celtic Festival. With so many people, security is a must. So I spoke with the chief of public safety with Five Rivers Metro Parks.
We're very fortunate that year after year, this has been a very safe event. People come out, have a great time, very respectful of each other. So we've been very fortunate.
Partnering with Dayton Police, there are dozens of personnel who watch for medical emergencies and anyone in distress, whether it be on foot, on bicycles, ATVs, or one of their carts. There is always a volunteer, park ranger, or police officer that's close who can help if need be. Five Metro Parks also partners with the city of Dayton in order to have barricades set up and for streets to be blocked off. Cameras are also everywhere, some with live feeds that are all streamed back to the festival's command center.
I've seen a pretty regular and constant police presence, but not interfering with the festival at all.
I've seen a lot of people walking around with same shirts on and a lot of security around.
Nearly a year of planning goes into this massive event. And with so many previous Celtic festivals, officials have a comprehensive plan to make sure everything stays safe and enjoyable.
I feel 100% safe here, actually. I feel like there's a lot of places I could go if I felt like I had a problem or felt unsafe.
Now, Mark has told me that there have only been a couple of medical emergencies today, mostly involving dehydration. So stay safe this weekend and enjoy the sights, smells, and sounds of the Celtic Festival. In Dayton, Evan Bales, 2 News.